can you find yourself in a situation where you're like, my life's a living hell because of an oppressive government? Is that possible?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's still possible to be found in. So you might have to fight for your life. How's everyone doing out there? Back again. Welcome, modern day mystics, fellow truth seekers. We got an interesting episode here. It seems like Jordan Peterson is in trouble again. What's new?
Dr. Peterson.
Jordan Peterson. I'm good at that. So actually, we're just going to get right into this video because he's going to tell you what it's all about.
Hello, everybody watching and listening on YouTube and perhaps on the Daily Wire Plus platform. I'm having a discussion today with my daughter, Michaela. I asked her to interview me, I suppose, about what's happening in Toronto, Ontario, Canada at the moment on the professional front relationship to me. The Ontario College of Psychologists, which is the board that regulates the practice of psychology in Ontario and hypothetically protects the public interest, has levied a series of what are, in essence, lawsuits against me for unprofessional conduct pertaining primarily to my social media communication. And so they have decided in their wisdom that I am to be required to undertake a series of re-education lessons designed to ensure that I communicate in a manner they deem appropriate. And I have told them that there are no circumstances I can imagine under which I would be willing to do that. And the next step is to bring me before a public disciplinary hearing and then to suspend my clinical license. And so I'm making all of this public because I think people need to weigh in on whether I'm an alt-right Nazi, harmful, bastion of intolerable political thought with a troll-like army of pathological followers, or whether the college itself is a corrupt nest of social justice vipers hell-bent on envy and revenge and using the tiny fraction of people who are complaining to put forward their own brand of personal pathology and vindictiveness. And, well, I'll make everything public except for that which I can't do on legal grounds and let everybody decide for themselves. That's the plan. Because I might be wrong, and I guess if I am, I need to learn how.
Yeah, hit it. Okay. I'll tell you what I like about this. Because when the world was first introduced to Jordan Peterson, he was, like, edgy, right?
Yeah.
Like, he might even like that this is happening. I don't know. But but when we first were introduced to him, he had some edge to him, right? And then over time, he got, like, sort of, like, in more and more monetized and softened up and kind of like you'd see him on like a commercial for something like,
yeah.
So buy my new product. And you don't really want to see your like profit like that, right?
Yeah.
Not saying that he's my profit, okay? I've got my own issues with him. I've talked about it before.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I kind of like him too. I like him, and this is definitely the version of him that I think people like best is when he's up against the ropes. And he's got to like be like, I'm not a fucking bad guy.
He's so good with his words, man. I was like, did you practice that? Those vipers of vindictive blah, blah, blah.
It's a mouthful.
Oh my gosh, man. All right.
In any case, Michaela is going to talk to me for 90 minutes, and we're going to walk through some of this, and maybe you'll find that interesting, and maybe you won't. Why would you care? Well, that's, I guess, what you'll figure out if you listen to the talk. One reason might be, it's my opinion that the regulatory boards that govern professional conduct in Canada, particularly in the US as well, and in the West more broadly, have become so corrupted by the woke ideology that the professionals you depend on in moments of crisis for legal advice and medical advice and psychological counseling, some of which can be life and reputation saving, they can no longer be trusted because they're being required by the professional bodies to lie to you in the service of this warped, radical leftist ideology that's now become, what would you call it, mandatory for right speakers wherever they might exist. And so that's why you might want to listen and decide for yourself whether you think that might be true. So anyways, onward with the discussion. And thanks, Michaela, for agreeing to do this.
All right. There's a lot there going on. It looks like, you know, we've talked a lot about free speech, and it looks like his claim is that it is under attack by the so-called woke leftists, that we won't be able to communicate outside of what they deem appropriate speech.
Right.
And first let me say that we're not a channel that's here to, like, attack the left-wing woke people. That's not what we're here to do. And I'm actually going to do some episodes that are speaking from the other side of things, too.
Sure.
So I don't want anyone out there to think that we're, you know, some right-wing thing. It just
depends on my mood, man. If you're watching this, you should know right away, sometimes I'm a staunch conservative, and sometimes I'm a freaking left-a-roni.
Yeah. But this is trending right now. It's going on in our country. And if you're from the States or you're in the West, you're probably seeing this too. It feels like free speech is being attacked for one side, because I think predominantly for the last few years, it's probably been pretty left-leaning in Western cultures.
Yeah.
For progressive cultures. And now it seems like, and he's saying, we should be concerned, we should care about the fact that our fundamental rights are being taken away
right.
from us, to be able, like, who gets to decide what is appropriate speech?
Right.
Right? And I think it's very important, if you've watched any of our last videos, especially the one with the comedian there, that where we be able to have discourse and be able to talk to each other.
Right.
Even if it's sometimes, you know, offensive or, you know,
I'll tell you what the problem is, because there's a few things right away. Some of the things, as far as I know, Peterson has warned people about, this is coming, buckle.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Did come and happen. And
yeah, yeah.
Things like he fucking was warning you about. Do people ever collectivize and do fucked up shit that they all thought was right, and then history remembers it another way? Yeah, that
yeah.
happens too. People do things thinking they're doing the right thing or thinking they're winning or whatever they are, and then it does not work out in the end. So check your heart, right?
Yeah.
But the other thing is, I know people that really care about stuff that put the legwork in to, like, fight these things. Like that artist I was telling you about, Umami?
Yeah.
Like, did you hear about this Bill C11 thing on YouTube? He's a creator,
yeah.
And I think he went to like fight that, and I don't know how it turned out. I don't know if he was successful in his endeavor. I should probably know that, but
yeah.
It's hard to know the level to which you should do something or give a damn or whatever
yeah.
when things seem too big or out of your hand, right?
Yeah.
Like, he's a powerhouse, and things he warned about fucking happened anyway.
Yeah.
You know, so maybe the idea is, if you're not liberal, maybe the message you need to hear is, like, seriously, get your ass in gear. Start trying harder. Tell your friends, go to dinner parties and fucking be rude and, you know, or be as manipulative as the side you think is doing it to get their way. You know, something's happening here.
Oh, yeah.
And so whatever you do care about, you probably should care and try,
yeah.
you know. Because can you find yourself in a situation where you're like, my life's a living hell because of an oppressive government? Is that possible?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that's still possible
yeah.
to be found in. So you might have to fight for your life.
Yeah, it's and I understand the troublesome, like why it bugs people. It actually, believe me, it bothers me. We have a YouTube channel here right now. We're from Canada, and we have some pretty progressive laws coming down the pipeline.
Sometimes they go backwards in time. What if they go back and they're like, hey, we found this thing, by the way, that you said several years ago, back when it was not an issue and everybody was okay with it, or just a minority of people weren't, but if things have reversed now, so off to jail you go. Very Nazi style, by the way. That's something
yeah.
a freaking, that's not like a humane way to approach
yeah.
past mistakes.
Yeah, yeah, it can be concerning, and
but people are gonna get fed up, man. They are gonna. You're seeing somebody irritated right now.
It's already happening. And I think, I don't know, maybe it's just me. I like to try and take a calculated balance approach, and maybe that's not right. Maybe you need to explode sometime. Lash out. I don't know. You guys tell us. It's hard to know what you said there, exactly what to do in the times that you're in. We're voicing our opinion on this channel about this. Sure, I want to have the freedom to be able to say what I want to say without worrying about some higher up entity, you know, watching what I'm doing and be like, no, sorry, censored on YouTube, we're kicking you off. Fuck, okay, I just built this goddamn room.
My opinion of things are like, TikTok is a psyop. Because you'll see the people that are literally trying to look as ugly as possible, like that's what they're trying. They'll be like, I'm making ugly face. And they'll have thousands of views. Thousands of people being like, you're so pretty. Like, you are prettier than everyone. Like, fucking lying. You're a liar. That's not even the truth, you know? And so, with all these platforms and like this, you know, your new generation is frightening and fucking scary. What is with that? You're like saying good's bad and evil's this and that. All this shit. You know? It's terrifying. And get a grip. Because things can get out of hand. And if you just allow it to happen, if we don't start hashtag TikTok's a fucking psyop, then maybe people will be like, I guess I gotta like shave half the side of my head and like, you know, be a weirdo. You know? And people are like, that's fucking hate speech. You know? Okay, but you think me saying you're a weirdo is hate speech, but you're calling me a fucking asshole. So you're hating on me for hating your thing. We hate each other. People have been doing that since the dawn of time. But if you lock me up for hating you, what's going on?
Yeah.
You know, like, I'm not locking you up.
Yeah.
You're gonna try to lock me up?
Yeah.
And by the way, sometimes I'm the guy with the, look at the fucking shirt I'm wearing. I can do weird things too. But it gets ugly when it becomes oppressive. What's with this like victim becoming oppressor thing? Don't do that.
Yeah.
You know, I know life's hard, but it's hard for everyone. You have to like, you know, I probably didn't even approach this the right way. Be more controlled than me.
All right. Well, anyway, folks, we want to know what you think about this. That's it's been a question going around. Is free speech under attack, or are we starting to realize that maybe we've taken this a little too far and you see maybe light on the other side of the tunnel? Or maybe you think we're wrong about this. Let us know what you think. We want to hear about it in the comments. Like always, guys, thank you for hearing us out. Hey, thank you for hearing our rants and our raves. It's great to have you guys here. If you like the episode, don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, share with a friend, and everybody, until next time,
stay spiritual.